Mr. Chair, earlier, Attorney Roque likewise stated that Whirlwind is the agent of Lucky South. Does our resource speaker confirm this, Mr. Chair?
Yes, po.
And can agency be implied?
Well, it can be implied, but an agency, once delegated, cannot be further delegated. Yun po ang rule.
Can it be done verbally?
Well, agency is written or verbal. Pero ang sinasabi ko nga po, yung delegated authority to Kasiong cannot be delegated any further. Ang pwede lang po mag-delegate talaga ay yung principal.
And what therefore is your concrete basis why you reached the conclusion that Whirlwind is an agent of Lucky South 99?
Well, una-una, Mr. Chair, because that is how Whirlwind explained it to me. And under the circumstance na sila nagpapaupa ng property nila at may interest sila na magkapatuloy ang negosyo ng Lucky South, nakita ko naman po kung ano ang interest din ng Whirlwind. Ang interest ng Whirlwind ay magpatuloy po ang negosyo nung nag-uupa sa kanila, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair, I want to go to the basic. Agency is a contract where there are two parties involved, the agent and the principal. It is hard to conceive, Mr. Chair, that Attorney Roque will be relying on the representation only of Whirlwind without an active participation of the other party who is supposed to be the principal, the Lucky South 99. And even assuming that indeed Whirlwind is an agent of Lucky South, I hope we are reminded as well by the principle that the act of the agent is the act of the principal, and the liability of the agent is the liability of the principal. Similar to attorney-client relationship, there is a fiduciary relationship that is existing between the principal and the client. So I wish to conclude, Mr. Chair, that Attorney Roque's representation did not cover only the Whirlwind, but extends even to Lucky South. Mr. Chair.